Hi, I'm Kevin Hogan with Rock Island Auction Company, and I'm standing here today with my friend, firearms expert, Richard Ellis. We're here today to tell you about our upcoming September 7th, 8th, and 9th Premiere Firearms Auction. We've called this sale our most anticipated auction in our company's history. The sale is comprised of four key collections, all different in their scope, but share a common theme of high quality, rarity, and diversity. The first, the Gateway Collection, of rare Colt single actions, percussions, Winchesters, Smith & Wessons, and other early 18th and 19th century arms. The second, the William Ashby Collection, comprised of Derringers and early Marshall pistols. The third, the William Doc Janet Collection, of high condition, rare Civil War arms. And the Michael Barrett Collection, of 18th, 19th, and 20th century military headgear. Richard, let's go through this mixed bag of guns we have in front of us.
Well, this mixed bag is probably one of the finer examples of our early 19th century U.S. Marshall pistols and rifles that are here, which begin with like the 1808 Navy North pistol, which would have predated the War of 1812. And then it goes as late, the latest gun here would be the Lee Arms Milwaukee, Wisconsin Civil War carbine, which came right at the end of the Civil War, and very few ever survived anywhere close to the condition of this specimen. You mentioned the Janicek collection. That was his prize in his collection. He was from the Milwaukee area, and that was one of his most
hometown pride and
so we can bounce back when we're relating to condition. We have both ends of the spectrum. Some of the weapons that are in that level of condition would be this Mississippi rifle that was with the Merrill conversion, which, as you recall, you've had the Merrill Civil War carbine. So look at the condition. It came from the U.S. Cartridge Company collection. It's brand new. This began life as a standard model 1841 Mississippi rifle, which is here, and that's just an as-issue specimen. Came from the same collection. You can see his eye for quality.
Right.
54 caliber with this type of sight. And then in the Civil War, they did the conversions with a long range sight, and they went to 58 caliber. So the Mississippi was a popular rifle, and these are the finest examples known within their respective configurations with their original buffed white slings, which is just phenomenal. These are great. So of this, we've pretty well covered the top end of the rack. Below that, it's tough for me not to point out this Whitney Plymouth naval rifle from the Civil War, still in 69 instead of the 58 caliber. It's in the original National Armory bright finish, which, as you'll notice, the bands are a little higher polished than the barrel. That means this gun never was ever repolished. That's the original polish on it. Has the same way as the condition of the Mississippi's. It has that wonderful raised feather grain wood. Below that, in guns that are extremely rare, maybe not the condition, would be this 1855 Sharps carbine with the Maynard tape roll primer, and it's Marshall inspected. I can't recall, we might have had one of those. Below that is an American Green carbine. They made several hundred of those in 45 caliber, as you recall, with a tin finish. That's an extremely rare gun that's always missing in the Civil War carbine collectors' collections. Staying along the area right directly preceding the Civil War was this stock Dragoon, Colt Dragoon. We've sure been through the Colts, but there is definitely a crossover with the Marshall inspection on the shoulder stock. You can talk about that Pettengill revolver right there in the double action with the Marshall inspector. It's extremely rare. You have, from the Civil War, a Lee Matt combination revolver shotgun pistol that was made the South, the Confederacy used these. You can look at the condition this gun was used, but most Confederate arms were. Backing up to the other Marshall pistols we missed, here is the Harper's Ferry. It's one of my favorites. It looks like a Kentucky pistol, but yet this was a Marshall inspected pistol, model 1805. And last but not least, in the Marshall pistols before me is this U.S. 1842 Aston pistol, also in the original polish. And look at the wood.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful gun. not to miss the edged weapons, the companion piece for the Mississippi rifle was that Ames rifleman knife. Those are near impossible to find. And that one has the original sheath, just in exemplary condition. And just to give us a little brief overview of our diversity in the collection, how could you not have a Marshall collection without swords? That's true. Those, I just picked a few of them to show here, both of which are Ames, and they're of the 1820, 1830 period, but they're just very interesting. In fact, the one with the fluted bone grip with the relief eagle and the silver hilted one below it with the eagle cross guard. They're just very attractive, and these are highly underrated.
Sure.
You know, a few thousand dollars buys you one heck of a piece in these swords. They're just great value. So I turn it over to you, Kevin.
You really hit it on the head. For such a wide scope, it's here. If you want Civil War arms, you want early martial arms, but we have Winchesters, we have 1/1000, 73s, Colt single actions, percussions. We have a Gatling gun, a fantastic original 1890 Gatling gun, German Lugers, sniper rifles, U.S. arms, shotguns, you name it, we have it for sale this September 7th, 8th, and 9th. If you get a chance, check out our website, www.rockislandauction.com. Hope to see you at the sale.